Well, Lucas Lesio, a very bright spot for the St. Mike's Buzzers, and they now look ahead to what really is their season on Sunday. We touched on it before, as it's really going to come down to the game against Orangeville, and Orangeville winning tonight 7-0, so they're coming off a hot win. Two teams really colliding, going in the same direction. Orangeville probably dominating a little bit more than St. Mike's did tonight. For the Buzzers, it must be simplify.
Yeah, and I think you're absolutely right. Simplifying is never a bad thing to keep your game, end up making less mistakes that way. But for the Buzzers to beat the Orangeville Crushers on Sunday afternoon, I think they're going to need to have their top players show up and be their top players like they were here tonight. Dan Champini had a goal. Lucas Lesio had a pair of goals and three assists for 5 points on the night, including a highlight reel effort. Jesse Beamish had a goal. And then they're going to need some depth scoring. Depth scoring cannot be understated, or at least its value in the playoffs. And they got that from guys like Tyler Forbes and Joe Luongo stepping up with some goals from some, I wouldn't say unlikely sources, but guys who are not at least relied on to provide the bulk of the offense, like Champini, Beamish, and Lesio. And that's the way they're going to have to win ultimately as well when they get into the playoffs. They will be facing a good team, whether it be Burlington or whether it be the Newmarket Hurricanes. I said it before and I'll say it again. Neither of those teams will be a cakewalk for the Buzzers. They will not be easy matchups. And they'll have to be at their best. And it starts not only with their best players being their best players, but showing up at the start of games, unlike they did here tonight against Dixie, Joe.
Now on the other side, it's North York and Stouffville. We haven't seen a lot of the spirit last year. We did last year in the old Central Division, and for the North York Rangers, they're going to want to win at all costs. They don't want to play the Burlington Cougars, and for Stouffville, they're trying to chase down the Markham Waxers, trailing them by 4 points with 2 games remaining. They're tied right now 2-2 in the third period, so a win tonight by Stouffville would put a whole bunch of other emphasis on that game.
Well, and that's exactly what you want if you're the fan of the Buzzers. You want something riding on the line for the Stouffville spirit in that game against the North York Rangers. You don't want it to be a meaningless game for them. You want them to have a reason to come out and play. And you're right, if they can ultimately catch Markham, that will be enough of an incentive for them to come out and win the game. For North York, though, I think if they win tonight, which it looks like they will, over the Upper Canada Patriots, that'll be 7 in a row. And if they can finish their season with an 8th consecutive win to take 7th place and end up facing the Newmarket Hurricanes, talk about a team going into the playoffs on a high. The North York Rangers, 8 wins in a row, that would be quite a way to go into the postseason.
Now, one more team that we haven't talked about, the remaining Toronto team, the Toronto Junior Canadians. They've been up and down this season, started off very hot through October and November, but they have also cooled off, and when you're heading into the playoffs, that's not necessarily something that you want.
No, it certainly isn't, and that's just what the Buzzers have been saying as well. They've wanted to find something to get into the playoffs on the right foot on, and you're right, the Junior Canadians have been equally as dubious, I think you could say, in terms of their lack of proficiency toward the end of the regular season here, and if anything, Dan Cameron will be making sure that his players, the head coach of the Toronto Junior Canadians, get going and get back to the way they were playing toward the end of last year when the Junior Canadians were really a team to be reckoned with and ultimately went all the way to the Central Division Finals until the Wellington Dukes ultimately knocked them off to move on further in the playoffs. But the Junior Canadians, they're a team that can really surprise you. If they can get going, they can beat any team in this league.
So the playoff stage just about set. Not all the picture clear yet. St. Mike's, one more game to go. They've got everything riding on it. That is Sunday against the Orangeville Crushers. Let's send it back down to Melanie.
Thanks a lot, guys. So the Buzzers needed to come up tonight with a big win. They did. They turned things around in the third period. Tyler Forbes stepped it up, got the game-winning goal. Dahlia played a great third period. They were able to pick up the win, get the 2 points. One game left in the season. That's going to determine who they meet first round in the playoffs. For the playoff schedule, stay tuned to cchl.com. They'll have all the updates on the playoff schedule, and tune into rogerstv.com. That's where you'll find out what games we're broadcasting. On behalf of Joe Pogue, Dave McCarthy, the entire Rogers production team, I'm Melanie Camilleri. Thanks for watching.